गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द क्लास ऑफ एचटीएमएल एंड ओपन योर बुक्स एट द पेज नंबर 26। टिल नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द टॉपिक दैट इज फॉर्म, मींस हाउ टू क्रिएट अ फॉर्म। फॉर दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इनपुट एलिमेंट, टाइप एलिमेंट, टेक्स्ट बॉक्स, पासवर्ड, रेडियो बटन, चेक बॉक्स एंड ड्रॉप डाउन लिस्ट। एंड इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस दैट हाउ टू क्रिएट सबमिट बटन, रीसेट बटन, टेक्स्ट एरिया एंड फील्ड सेट। सो इन द बुक्स वी आर हैविंग टॉपिक दैट इज सबमिट। स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव क्रिएटेड डिफरेंट कंट्रोल्स लाइक टेक्स्ट बॉक्सेस, passwords, radio button, check boxes, and we are filling our form. After filling the form, we need to submit our form. Means this form will be submitted to the concerned authority with the different softwares. For that, we need to design a button, and the name of that button is submit button, and its key term is submit button allow you to submit the form. And its syntax is input. Input means I need to create a control. Type. Type means which type of control I want to design. And we will type the control, that is submit. Means I need to create a submit button. For that, come to the practical work so that you can make it more clear. Come to the notepad. And at the end of our form, which we had discussed in the last lectures, we will do, that is, we will do BR to bring the cursor to the new line. After that, I will write input type is equal to in double quotes submit. And if I want to write the name on that button according to my choice, means whatever the name I need, I want to display on that button. For that, we are having its attribute, that is value. Value is equal to whatever I will write that will display on the that button. Means I have done input type is equal to submit. And its value means a text will display on my screen, that will save. Now I save my work, I'll close it, I'll double click on it, and see at the end this save button comes. That button is used to submit our form. We will fill our form and at the end we will submit our form. Now come to the next topic. According to the book, next topic we are having, that is reset button. What is the function of reset? Once a user fill the form and the next user want to fill the form, or we want the by default settings of the forms, then we are using this reset button. And what is the function of this reset button? This button allow you to restore the form into its original state. Means if I have filled the form, next form I want to fill, and I want to make my form clear with the default settings, then I will use this reset button. And its syntax is same as the submit, only on the place of submit we will write reset. Now see it practically. Come to the notepad, open with notepad, and at the end I'll copy this coding of submit and I'll paste on the place of submit. I will type reset, and on the place of value I will write any text. Let's suppose I want to write clear. I'll save my work, I'll close it, and I will show you the output. Now see the output of the reset button. I'll open my work. Now see, this button comes that is clear. Whatever the value I have written, that comes on this button. Let's suppose I am filling the form with the name, password, properties, radio button I chose. I choose that one, cricket, Amritsar. And now I want to clear this form. I want to reset this form to fill the next form. For that, I will click on this clear button. And my form is clear and it becomes with the default properties of the forms as a original form. That is a work of this reset button. Now, next topic in our book, that is text area. In the text control, we have discussed that whenever we need to write a single line text, that we can write with the text box control. But when we need to write the text in the more than one line or in the several lines, then we are using this text area. And what is the function of this text area? Key term. Its key term is it allows you to enter several lines of text. Means multiple line text we can enter with the help of this text area control. And its syntax is text area cols. Cols means the columns, means what columns I need to write, means 4-column box I want, 5-box column I want, whatever. That I will write. Rows means how much rows I need, multiple lines, that I will write. And at the end, I will close this text area. Now, I'll show you practically that how to use the text area. I will open my notepad. And before doing the submit button, I want the text area. I will write text area without space, rows is equal to, let's suppose I want 5 rows, space, cols. We will write cols for columns. Let's suppose I want 10 columns. I'll close it and I will close this text area. I have opened the text area tag and I close it, so it is also a container tag. Rows means how much width I want. Columns means how much height I want of the text area for the multiple lines. I can write according to my wish and at the end I will close this text area. I'll save my work. I'll show you the output for that. That is, I'll double click on it. See, I have this box. This box having 5 rows and that columns which I have typed. Let's suppose I'm writing something that will go down to down. Multiple lines I can write. Scroll bar came till the 10 lines will come. But in the text box, I can write single line text. But in the text area, I can write multiple lines. That is the difference between text area and the text box. Now, I have cleared the form. Now, come to the book. Next topic we are having, that is field set. What is the function of field set? Field set is used to group the form elements together. Means I want to make the groups of my form controls, then I will use this field set. And its syntax is field set open. We will use our controls. 2 controls I want, 3 controls I want, I'll use that. And at the end I will close this field set. Now I will show you practically that how to use it. For using field sets, we will open our notepad and we will use the field set. For that, let's suppose in our form, I want to start the field set before enter your name and at the end of the password, I want to close this field set. I'll close it. I'm opening this tag and closing it, so it is a container tag. After that, before choose your gender, I want to start next field set. I'll start it. And I want to make the group of radio buttons and checkbox. So after the checkbox, I will close it. I'll close it. Now see the output after saving. See, now my form come in these boxes, these lines. These lines makes these two controls in a one group. I have started before enter your name and password. One box come. This box make the group of this text box and password. And next again I have started field set choose your gender and till the football means at the end of the checkbox. So this become my second group of controls of radio buttons and checkboxes. Students, in these lectures we have discussed that how to design the form with different controls like the text boxes, passwords, radio buttons, checkboxes, drop down list, text area, submit button and reset button. On the basis of this, we have given you different project works. Do that project works with the help of schoolings. Thank you so much.